Hello everyone, how are you all my dear students? I hope you all are fine and enjoying your studies well. So my dear students, I hope you all are ready with your grammar textbook, and if you don't have it, then be ready with your rough book. So as you all know from a previous lecture, we have started textual explanation and exercise, means explanation from the textbook and its exercise. So my dear students, as you all know, every day first we are doing revision of a previous video, then we move to our present topic. So same we will do today. Today first we will revise topics of previous video, that what we have learned in a previous video, and afterwards we will start with the next topic. So let's begin with a beautiful quote. Let's see. Nobody can go back and start a new beginning, but anyone can start today and make a new ending. Nobody can go back and start a new beginning, but anyone can start today and make a new ending. Means, nobody can go in the past, but everybody can make a bright future, right? So, first, let's revise what we have learned in a previous video. So, in a previous video, in previous lecture, we have started with here lesson number 10, simple tenses. Read these sentences. Let's see. Water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. Water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. The earth rotates on its axis. The earth rotates on its axis. My mother swims every day. My mother swims every day. Father cooked pasta yesterday. Father cooked pasta yesterday. Sheila will go to London tomorrow. Sheila will go to London tomorrow. Verbs change forms to tell us when an action happened. These different forms are called tenses. Verbs change forms to tell us when an action happened. These different forms are called tenses. There are three kinds of tenses. There are three kinds of tenses. So, let's see. In the previous video, we have completed one part. Read these sentences. Read these sentences. Asin gets up early every day. Asin gets up early every day. It rains every afternoon. It rains every afternoon. Your exam starts at 8 a.m. Your exam starts at 8 a.m. The earth revolves around the sun. The earth revolves around the sun. I go to my grandmother's house every week. I go to my grandmother's house every week. On Mondays, Harjeet sings in the choir. On Mondays, Harjeet sings in the choir. The highlighted verbs tell us about actions that happen daily as a routine or are universal facts. The highlighted verbs tell us about actions that happen daily as a routine or are universal facts. The sentences that show habitual actions or universal truths or facts are said to be in the simple present tense. The sentences that show habitual actions or universal truths or facts are said to be in the simple present tense. Note, some of the signal words for the simple present tense are always, often, usually, seldom, never, every day, every morning, on Sundays. These are the signal words. Now, let's see the exercise. Match column A with column B. Match column A with column B. So let's see. Coins, jingle. Coins, jingle. Dry leaves, rustle. Dry leaves, rustle. Bells, ring. Bells, ring. Doors, slam. Doors, slam. Pressure cookers, whistle. Pressure cookers, whistle. Coins, jingle. Dry leaves, rustle. Bells, ring. Pressure cookers, whistle. Now, let's solve the next exercise. Let's revise the next exercise. Ravi dash every morning. Ravi baths every morning. These children dash sandcastles every evening. So the answer is, these children build sandcastles every evening. C. A camel dash people across the desert. Answer, carries. A camel carries people across the desert. You dash beautifully. Dance. You dance beautifully. Then next is, my grandfather dash beautiful kites. Make. Answer, makes. My grandfather makes beautiful kites. Rohini dash to school every day. So the answer is, Rohini walks to school every day. A boy dash for marbles usually. Rohini walks to school every day. That boy dash for marbles usually. Quarrels. That boy quarrels for marbles usually. Then, many women dash silk saris. Like. Many women like silk saris. Then next is, we dash tea and not coffee. We drink tea and not coffee. An elephant dash heavy objects easily. Lift. An elephant lifts heavy objects easily. Meeta dash hockey at school. Meeta plays hockey at school. The moon shines brightly in the sky. Answer is shines. The moon shines brightly in the sky. So now let's begin with the today's topic. Let's begin with today's topic. So here it is. Read these sentences. Read these sentences. Mona brought some sweet for me. Mona brought some sweets for me. She wanted the toy. She wanted the toy. Anna dropped the glass. Anna dropped the glass. I sold my car last year. I sold my car last year. The highlighted verbs tell us about actions that happened in the past. The highlighted verbs tell us about actions that happened in the past. So, the sentences that show actions that have been completed are said to be in the simple past tense. The sentences that show actions that have been completed are said to be in the simple past tense. Note, some of the signal words for the simple past tense are yesterday, this morning, last year, last month, last holidays. Yesterday, this morning, last year, last month, last holidays. Now, see here. We add ed at the end of some verbs to make their past forms. These are called regular verbs. So, in brief, already we have discussed and we have learned. We add ed at the end of some verbs to make their past forms. These are called regular verbs. Simple present tense and simple past tense. Simple present tense and simple past tense. So let's see here. Dance. Danced. Dance. Danced. Point. Pointed. Point. Pointed. Talk. Talked. Talk. Talked. Wonder. Wondered. Wonder. Wondered. Visit. Visited. Visit. Visited. Paint. Painted. Paint. Painted. Now let's see the next one. Some verbs change completely in their past forms. Some verbs change completely in their past forms. These are called irregular verbs. These are called irregular verbs. So let's see here. Simple present tense and simple past tense. simple present tense and simple past tense. Write, wrote. Write, wrote. Sing, sang. Sing, sang. Eat, ate. Eat, ate. Buy, bought. Buy, bought. Draw, drew. Ride, rode. Now, let's solve the exercise. Fill in the blanks with the simple past tense of the verbs in brackets. So, let's start the exercise. Amir rushed home from school around 5 in the evening. So, the correct answer is rushed. Amir rushed home from school around 5 in the evening. He washed himself quickly and dashed to the kitchen for a glass of milk. So the answer is washed. He washed himself quickly and went to the kitchen for a glass of milk. Though it was hot, he drank it fast. Then he dashed out his notebooks and dashed his homework. So the answer is took and completed. After finishing his homework, he dashed to the field to practice for the volleyball match. So the answer is ran. After finishing his homework, he ran to the field to practice for the volleyball match. He dashed for one hour. Answer is practiced. He practiced for one hour. Then he dashed back home as it was getting dark. Answer is cycled. Then he cycled back home as it was getting dark. He dashed his bicycle in the backyard and bathed again. Answer is parked. He parked his bicycle in the backyard and bathed again. Then he switched on the television and watched his favorite sports channel. Then he switched on the television and watched his favorite sports channel. So, my dear students, I'm giving you a time of a few seconds to complete this work. So, I hope you all have written this. So, let's move to the next topic. I shall write the essay tomorrow. I shall write the essay tomorrow. Asha will help us to decorate the room. Asha will help us to decorate the room. Then it will rain tomorrow. It will rain tomorrow. They will leave the city soon. They will leave the city soon. The highlighted verbs tell us about actions that will happen in the future. The highlighted verbs tell us about actions that will happen in the future. The sentences that show actions that will happen in the future are said to be in the simple future tense. The sentences that show actions that will happen in the future are said to be in the simple future tense. Note, we use shall or will along with the verb to show future tense. We use shall or will along with the verb to show future tense. Shall is usually used with I and we. Shall is usually used with I and we. For example, I shall make noodles tonight. I shall make noodles tonight. Will is usually used with any other pronoun or noun. Will is usually used with any other pronoun or noun. For example, my father will buy me some story books. My father will buy me some story books. Now, let's solve the exercise. That is exercise number 4. Fill in the blanks with the future tense of the verbs in brackets. Fill in the blanks with the future tense of the verbs in brackets. So, let's see. I dash my homework tonight. So, it's very easy. You just had to add will. I will finish my homework tonight. I will finish my homework tonight. Anita dash design clothes for the dancers. So, the answer is will design. Anita will design clothes for the dancers. Anita will design clothes for the dancers. My classmates dash Darjeeling next month. Will visit. My classmates will visit Darjeeling next month. So, let's see these three blanks. I will finish my homework tonight. Then next, Anita will design clothes for the dancers. My classmates will visit Darjeeling next month. Now, the next blank. It's very easy. The clouds dash into large drops of rain soon. Answer is will burst. The clouds will burst into large drops of rain soon. Next, my father dash to you how he made the toy car. Answer is my father will explain to you how he made the toy car. Next, I dash out the story I have written. I will read out the story I have written. So now, let's revise these three blanks. The clouds will burst into the large drops of rain soon. My father will explain to you how he made the toy car. I will read out the story I have written. Now, next FB, that is, I dash the letters tomorrow. I dash the letters tomorrow. I will post the letters tomorrow. I will post the letters tomorrow. We dash for your call tonight. We will wait for your call tonight. My principal dash a presentation on Monday. My principal will make a presentation on Monday. So now let's revise these three blanks. I will post the letters tomorrow. We will wait for your call tonight. My principal will make a presentation on Monday. Now, the next blank. My brother dash a team of doctors very soon. So, will head. My brother will head a team of doctors very soon. Then, the tree dash its leaves in winter. The trees will shed its leaves in winter. We dash on the slide for an hour. We will play on the slide for an hour. So, my dear students, this is the image which is given in your textbook. This is the image which is given in your textbook. You can see here. So, this is the end of the lesson. So, regarding today's session, if you are having any doubts, feel free to message me on my WhatsApp number. I hope you all have understand this lesson properly and you have written each and everything in your textbook or the rough book. Okay. So, we will meet in our next session with the next topic. Till then, take care of yourself. Bye-bye.